open up your eyes, baby.
I can never be controlled. Let them know. 500 helicopters driving me guns low. But they want you just to envy. Let them see. I'm the first to say it. Now it's time you just believe it. I got too many fakes. Made lots of foes. These people cold. Talk down your dreams because they know they can't come close. Don't shake no hands. They'll steal your friends. I walk alone. I see false idols. All the titles you need to grow.
Have you lost your mind?
But I ain't like the others no more. God, I'm learning lessons as I go.
You're only wasting time.
Tell the devil there's a door. Praying God is only trying to test me for the
throne.
My God, oh God, this is on a God level. The sun, the sky, you can see the vibe. We ride the high, always on a high level. So open up your eyes, baby.
Got so many memories that I made on Casket Road. I done gained the world, I ain't never sell my soul. This is God-given, so I thank him as I go. Hate to sound conceited, but I know, I know, I know. Crazy thing they f*** with me. Yeah, crazy thing they f*** with me. Run up on me, baby, show you gon' see. Yeah, God power from my head and my feet. Yeah. Colossal, what I say is gospel. I cook this with love, they gon' eat it up and swallow me. I'm from the ghetto, babe. Seen bodies in the street before I could tweet. I came from nothing. I turned a mustard seed into a million in the discussion. Had a TED talk with the higher me, show me how to run it up. I need all my cheese. Every day that I wake up, I'm pinching myself. Can't believe that I'm really me. Popping shows in New Zealand, boy, you is not eating, man. We do not play in the same league. I gave my mama some racks and she asked me if I'm selling tricks. I said, mama, please. If I was, do you think I'd let you know? Got so many memories that I made on Cascade Road. This is God-given, so I thank her as I go. This gon' sound conceited, but I know, I know, I know. Crazy thing they f*** with me.
Hey.
Yeah,
hey.
Crazy thing they f*** with me.
Hey.
Yeah, got power from my head to my feet.
Hey.
Yeah, run up on me, baby, so you gon' see.
Hey.
I chase, I just attract. What you put in, you get back. I'm screaming Campbell, then Campbell, then still hit the dance in the wherever I'm at. Feel like a champion, mama mentality. I am the masterpiece, life is the crap. Deep love me and I can't resist it, but I'm only guilty of slipping too fast. Life is my legacy, what lies ahead of me, helping it get peace with his past. Little bitty regular that I pack. 007 before you react.
Don't think twice, my only advice for my granddad before he passed. Look to the stars, look at the sky at night. Tell me that heaven ain't black on everything I love. Try not to brag till you bring it up. Turn of vision, block opinions, and I can give a but think of us. Duck, jab, hook, send it through the roof with an uppercut. Tell the truth, shut the devil up. In the booth, I'm a touchable. Crazy thing they with me.
Crazy thing that with me.
Hey.
Run up on me, baby, so you gon' see.
Hey.
Yeah. God power for my head and my feet.
Hey.
Yeah.
what the folks around here like to call the Vault, and that's Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Tonight, we finish off week six with a good Monday nighter between the Seattle Seahawks and the Carolina Panthers. Set to go now in week six of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Jet sweep to start the drive. And he'll hope that this is not a sign of what's in store as he has to fight just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
Here's 2nd and 10. Now Darnold. In a double coverage, and it's intercepted. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
Man, I wonder if someone's down there checking on the head coach right now, because he might be in a little bit of shock after what just transpired. Instead of a lengthy opening drive to deal with, his guy stepped up and stole that drive away. Momentum on their side now. How will they attack on offense?
Walker now on 1st and 10. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. 2nd and 2. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
Hey. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's 2nd and a couple. Oh, they're going to run a little pop pass here. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
And that's something you have to get ready for defensively, because in today's NFL, teams will use their wide receivers on jet sweeps, end arounds. They'll move them back in the backfield and make them running backs. Partner, this was much more of a tap pass, but effective nonetheless.
And I think both guys love it. If you're a quarterback, it's an easy completion. If you're a wide receiver, you get the easy reception and also a chance to try to make a play with your feet. Out of the gun, Walker with it. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a 2nd and just about a few inches here.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive linemen creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
Keep in mind, they can still get a first down here as they come up on 2nd and inches. Sticking with Walker on 2nd down. And he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. Kenneth Walker, his 2nd rushing touchdown on the year. And the Seahawks use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now a 7-0 game. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. Taken at the goal line. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, or they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. They'll run for the first time here with Brian Robinson. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. The Panthers in a very solid 4-1 here in the early part of the year. And they coming off their very first loss of the season, suffered a week ago.
So now we can all take that chasing the 1972 Dolphins, take it and throw it right out the window, right? But let's face it, not many teams talk about that or even have interest in it. All they want to do right now is bounce back after that loss.
On second and seven, Darnold. And he fires one incomplete. Well, this defense for the Seahawks, they were very strong last week in that win over Cleveland.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
Throwing here on third down, Darnold. Taking a shot here for Marshall. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
But they certainly came out firing in this one, and while that one was incomplete, I can't imagine that'll be the last shot that they take in this game.
On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. And look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up two touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
So, Charles, you look at this offense. What a start to the season. 5 wins without a loss. When do you think that you start believing that maybe you're in the midst of something special?
Well, you and I both know every head coach never wants that thought to creep into a locker room. But the truth of the matter is, not quite at this time, because if we look at the Steelers in 2020, they're a great example. Remember, they started 11-0, then lost 5 of 6 and went out in the first round. But I think if you get toward mid-November, the Thanksgiving time frame, and you're still doing this.
And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Ken Walker with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Seahawks are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Boy, Charles, this offense is just so explosive. They lead the league in scoring, and another example of just how good they are right there on that play.
Yeah, we often overstate about how explosive teams are. This team is truly a threat to score on every snap, especially on the first few plays of any series. And a big strike like that, that only adds to their reputation as the league's best offense.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. A short kick taken at the 18. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. A play fake, and it's Darnold. And he will find it. his big tight end over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
On first down, Darnold. His throw complete right side to the tight end, Parham. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receiver.
Touchdown, Panthers! Terrace Marshall, his third touchdown now on the year. Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. And that one makes it 14-7. The Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Well, this offense looks like they have a little extra pep in their step as they take the field here for drive number three, because remember, Charles, drives one and two both ended in the end zone.
Yeah, right now they've just got to be careful not to lean into overconfidence, because every drive has a life of its own. But I like the way that they've started, the way that they're going about doing things.
And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Kenneth Walker doing it again with his third touchdown here in the opening quarter. And the Seahawks have taken a two-touchdown lead now. Boy, still in the first quarter, and look out. I mean, they are on pace for over 80 points in this game. I don't know that they'll get there, CD, but this has been impressive to watch so far.
That certainly would be history in the making, wouldn't it, partner? I'm glad we're here to actually watch and see if it actually happens, although, like you, I have my doubts, but they are firmly in control of this game.
The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field, and we are ready to rock. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Right now, Charles, it just feels like they're trying to keep pace. They did score the touchdown last time out, but they still trail by double digits here. We'll see if this offense is once again up to the task.
Yeah, and I think that after the last drive, they've gotten pretty rubbed up, don't you think? Everything they were doing is working pretty well. They go back out there with the same mindset, play at the same tempo and the same pace. Still a lot of time left to make something happen in this one.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Now it's Darnold. And he'll go underneath here to Breida. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And it's second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Second down and a run by Robinson. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. Pretty wild first quarter. 21-7, our score. It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on third down. Here's Darnold. Checks this one down to Robinson. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as he's able to get 8 yards there on third and five.
But they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
So from Seahawk territory now, it's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Here's Darnold. And that's complete to the right side. It's Marshall. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 23 yards on the play. Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. He'll have to deal with a second and 14 now after the loss. To throw is Darnold. That'll be complete to Breida. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
Partner, normally double coverage reserved for receivers and tight ends, but this time they actually targeted the running back with it, and it still wasn't enough. He attacked the defense and got in a great position to haul in the catch and get a nice gain out of it.
Darnold now to throw. He'll dump this down to Matt Breida. And the Panthers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
They'll run with Robinson. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
This is a critical sequence here for this offense. Things really haven't gone their way so far. This could be their chance to get back into it, but they've got to find a way to punch this ball in.
On second and goal, Darnold. Middle of the field, it's Robinson. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. That catch good for 8, but still, it's third and goal now.
The defense was ready for the back to leak out and even had a second player waiting to double him up. If you're going to commit to doubling a back, you better prevent a completion, but give him credit. Extra determination, extra effort, turn it into a successful play.
Now Darnold on third and goal. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. From 4 yards out. And the Panthers are back within a score. And down near the goal line here, they're able to throw it in.
And the key word, quick. Quick hitter. Out of his hands fast, into the receiver's hands even faster.
Gonzalez good on the extra point. And they're back within a touchdown at 21-14. The Carolina kick team is out there ready to go, and they kick this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
to throw on second down. Coffee finding Lockett for the catch here on the out route. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. 10 yards into Seattle first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Throwing on first down, Coffey. And that's incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Off the play fake, Coffey. They'll roll him out right. He finds his man complete. That's Kramer. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. Coming into the week, he's the NFL's leader in receiving yards. There's his first catch, and it's good for a first down. The gun is Walker, and he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
If you're a coach, you'll absolutely take that run every time on first down because it really sets you up to go in a number of directions here on second.
Looking to throw on second down, Coffey. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
Play number seven coming on this drive. It's third and inches. They'll try for the first with Walker, and he gets it to the 32, good enough for a first down. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Throw, Coffey to the right side and complete to Metcalf, and he is out of bounds inside the 30, and just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away, and that will bring up second down. Operating from the gun, Coffey. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Had the right idea, though, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he left him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
Two is the line to gain here on third down. Looking to throw. Coffey. And that's knocked away and incomplete.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight on just about every throw. Forced a few here so far in this game, and now it brings up fourth down.
So out now is the Seattle field goal team. From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. And this one is right down the middle. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
Michael Dixon, the kickoff for Seattle.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll be out of bounds here, a yard shy of the 25 and the 24. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Well, not much time remains here in this first half. We'll see if they can get something out of this drive, at least a field goal. They could certainly use it. Down by two scores. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Brandon, so many times we see the crossing route start as a quick hitter, but in this play, he had time in the pocket and waited for him to clear going across.
First down, it's Darnold. He throws there, incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. Tight end here. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Again, Darnold. And it'll be caught in the end zone for the Carolina touchdown by DJ Moore. A great effort there as the first half is winding down. And the Panthers are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And that cuts the lead to 3, 24-21. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away from the 10. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Yetur Gross-Matos able to record his fifth sack of the season. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. Play of the first half. Now here's a little touch pass as they tap it quickly to their receiver. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30. Shot before break. Coffee. He sets to fire deep. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. This one fielded at the five. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in the second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be licensed to take some shots downfield.
Ready, set.
They go play action here on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
And those two just have been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect him to have more completions to him in this game.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Off play action, Coffey. He's got a man complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Give him 32 on the play.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Brian Burns, who wanted to bring him down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Throwing the out route, and he connects with Fant. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. So 8 yards on the completion there. And now we've got third down and four. On third down, here's Walker. And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
Someone's been having a good game so far. You know something? A lot has been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. Back to Walker on first down. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Off the play fake. Coffey. Under pressure and down he goes. The second back of the 36.
And they visited the end zone frequently in this one, and obviously they wanted another one. But give credit to the defense there. They may not make the comeback. Time showed it's on that play.
Ninth play of the drive now on third and a country mile. Back to throw. Coffey. Buying time to his left.
Well, he tries to force it in and it's intercepted.
And the Panthers are in great shape here as they take over at the 46-yard line. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10. And he'll be dropped at the 36. It's a good gain of 18 on a play that originated back at the 18. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled them with the inside run. I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Oh, that's good decision-making right there. Understood down and distance. Knew it wasn't third down, and he still had another opportunity to earn the first down. Good job throwing it away and avoiding an interception.
Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down. Back to throw, Darnold. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
And this defense definitely in his head there on third down, and he's pretty fortunate. They didn't call for grounding on this one. That was a good 10 feet over everyone's head.
Gonzalez's kick is good, and that will tie us at 24-all. But whatever was said in the locker room during the break must have worked. They forced the turnover. They didn't get the touchdown, Charles, but it does translate into 3 points to begin this second half.
Exactly as they discussed in the locker room at halftime. Get some points to get things kick-started. Now start your half off with some momentum. Gives you something to build on for your next possession.
And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in the second half. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. And they'll send the tight end in motion here. Now a play fake here on first down. Steps away to his left, and he wisely will throw that one away.
Well, sometimes an incompletion is the right play, and he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
Third quarter on a Monday night with a second and 10 coming up. Oh, they're going to run a little pop pass here. A nice play design there with the touch pass. Looked good at the start, but the defense was ready.
And they did a nice job scouting, didn't they? Not just scouting, but now executing once they saw the play for real after having worked on it all week in practice. They drilled on the play, then they drilled him.
The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. Looking to throw. Coffee. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Multiple defenders getting to him there for a huge loss.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
And here's Dixon to punt now as he gets this one away. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them three. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from a long distance?
Tight end goes in motion left. Back to Robinson now on first down. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. They'll set up a throw. It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
The plan was clearly to challenge them by sending a blitz on second down, but even the extra guys couldn't catch him in the backfield, though. He doesn't scramble for a first, but he does get the last lap by evading the blitz and getting beyond the line of scrimmage.
The offense on third down tonight, they've converted three out of five thus far. This will be third and five. They'll drop the throw. He's got a man. That's Marshall. They had a nice job there defensively. They get him to the ground short of the first, right around the 42. Short completion, just 4 yards. And that's going to make it fourth down.
I thought they might take a shot down the field, but instead they ran a little drag route there. I think they were hoping he could catch it and run away from the defender. But a really good job keeping the play in front of them, and they force a fourth down.
And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And they'll play keep away from the returner as this one will be marked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Pretty good spot. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity, all tied in the fourth quarter. And he goes down at the 26. A pickup of 13, and that last play began at the 13. First down.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch victory.
The slot man in motion right. And going right back to Walker. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 226 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Back to throw. Coffey. Throw out wide to Walker. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
And partner, in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
On the counter is Walker, and they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Sticking with Walker on second down. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they'll get him behind the line. They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of the scrimmage. And now 3rd and 11 coming up. Thinking about the possible field goal on fourth, it would be 58 yards from here. Off play action. Coffey sliding out of the pocket. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. Give him 9 on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Thanks to his effort, they now have a big choice to make here. He just ran them into field goal range with that one, so here come the choices. Do they kick it here, or do they trust him to make another big play and possibly get a first down?
And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. Less than 2 to play with just a field goal separating these two sides. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. A short kick taken at the 18, and he'll be stopped up at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. 1st and 10. Here's Darnold. Oh, Darnold loses it. And the Seahawks have picked it up. And this defense has broken it open as they return it to the house for 6. This was a close game. They needed a little breathing room. Boy, they got it right there on that return for a touchdown.
Yeah, we would say that this could be huge. Forget it. It was huge. Gave them a comfortable lead.
Point after, right down the middle. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And let's just say they're going to be looking to start over on this drive. A few moments ago, they were in the exact situation, but their first play led to a fumble that was returned for 6.
Yeah, you definitely have to have a short memory to play in the NFL. You got to remember what you did wrong so you don't repeat it. But you can't dwell on it because then you will repeat it, and that's what you don't want to do. And let's face it, this defense has had its share of struggles all game long, and they know that they can put it all behind them if they defend well here in the 2-minute drill. Excellent coverage right there to force the incompletion.
Darnold. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Tariq thrown and picks it. And the Seahawks will take over here just shy of the 30. With the points that we've seen scored, neither defense has been at their best, but these guys, they've been a little bit better, Charles, and a nice interception there.
Yeah, you're right about that, Brandon. Let's face it. It's not always how you start, it's how you finish, right? So maybe you have a rough game all the way along, but if you make a big play like that at the right time, it can make everything turn out just okay.
And that's caught inside the 35. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. A great play there. 71 yards. And the Seahawks add on to their lead, and it's looking like that win streak is going to extend another week. Extra point right down the middle. And that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. On first and 10, it's Robinson. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Oh, there's plenty of traffic waiting for him up the middle. But give him credit, he tried barreling through anyway. They're fortunate to get a yard out of that one.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Robinson with another carry. And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down. One last throw now for Darnold. And he'll take this for a short gain on what will prove to be the final play of this ball game. And as this defense walks off the field, they can do so with their heads held high. What a performance by the offense, too. I mean, really, Charles, just complete domination on both sides of the football here in this one.
Certainly was, and I think both sides compete against each other all the time. You go to each other in practice, obviously your training camps, your offseason. But on game day, you both want to show your best. And I think that's what we saw for both the offense and the defense, a complete team victory.
So for the Seahawks, they remain as hot as anyone, 6-0 now through the first month and a half. And they'll return home next week to take on the Detroit Lions. Meanwhile, for Carolina, the loss will drop them to 4-2 on the year. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to MetLife Stadium to take on the New York Giants.